Shalom. So what's going on here? Let's see. Today is Tuesday, August 1st, 2017. It's 6 p.m. with 13 minutes. I am Raz Alonso Teferri, reporting for the Lion of the Tribe of Judah Society of His Imperial Majesty, Kedama Achel Selassie and His Christ Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach. And let's see, we're reporting off of I&I channel on YouTube, Rastafari Fellowship. Now, here we go. Basically, what is this about? Well, it's about the fact that we noticed one of our videos has been discontinued in certain countries. Here we go. That one. Jesus Christ, Crucifixion of Black Male in America. Now, if we play it. Hold up. We play it, we get that, I guess we get like that warning, and we get forwarded to another video. So basically what's going on, this is what we found out. It's not about the content necessarily, it's more about what is it, Merlin Red Eye Distribution. Apparently they blocked the video in the US, perhaps in other countries. Why? Well, because of the musical content. I do remember that we added some music to the storyline. So we really don't want to take time to present this at this moment, but we will, you know, for the video's sake, to keep it running, we'll do a short, review of the Crucifixion of Black Male in America. So, you think Christ went through this, you know, just for fun? He's the image and likeness of a certain people. And that certain people was to experience a certain tribulation, period. You know, no one escapes Jah's judgment. So, this is basically the Passion of Christ with a modern twist. Now, to me it's very important because it's a life experience. How deep did I get into it? Really doesn't matter. I know enough to be able to manifest this. So it means a lot to me. When I did this, I did it with the purpose of demonstrating that black males, Negroes in America, in the Americas throughout, cannot deny, whether religious or not, cannot deny that if they've been in the prison complex, that the story of Christ is very much like something we live in the hood, day in, day out. As a matter of fact, it says here, Yehud Negus, the king of the hood, Yehud Negus Nazareth U Jesus. Jesus of Nazareth, king of the Jews, king of the hood. Now, the Yehud. So basically a rundown. PC, politically correct. Protective custody, red suit, rat, snitch. Judas does the right thing, whether for money, convenience, whatever. Rats his homeboy out. What happens? Babylon gets sent forward. Cops raid. The homeboy that's innocent usually gets left hanging. Hanging where? On a tree. Homeboys run. They flee. And, all these jokers, these people playing dress up, these Pharisees, Sadducees, you know, like cops and robbers, whatever. Some fags in the background, excuse my language, taking the Torah to its most literal, you know, low thinking state, and, rejecting the one sent. Now, Babylon comes, they raid, homeboys flee, rat from within. Now we have something that we experience commonly. The arrest. Now we have a degradation here of what was a black man, an original black male, leprous, continuing his devolution to a zombie type individual, to a straight up clean leper blonde, to a heathen satanic devil. Why? Because they contemplate how to ruin him. Homeboy warming up in the fire, Peter, while he gets his beating. Stop resisting. We call this police department, Pharisee department, whatever. The beating of black male, and then the blindfolding, the slaps, the mockery, and what's next? Court. Tried in two jurisdictions, refused to be tried by Pilate once he knew that Yeshua belonged to Herod's jurisdiction. Herod laughed it off, didn't want to get involved, sent him back to Pilate. Pilate washes his hands. You know, Pilate probably thinking, I'm a Roman, I'm a savage, I'm a beast. I've seen things, I've done things, but this shit is wrong. This man appear to have no fault. Now I've killed, me Pilate, I've killed many people, I've murdered people, I enjoy it. But there's something weird about this. It seems like he ain't done nothing wrong. And homeboys over here are desperately trying to get rid of him. So Pilate ain't stupid. I've done a lot of dumb shit in my life, but this seems wrong. So he goes to humiliation of trials, courts, tribulations, reaches the mark, gets whipped with the scars of his humiliation, of his suffering, sprinkling those that have sinned upon him and that we've rejected him, you know, sprinkling them so that we too may be, you know, what could we say, tied into the matter through blood. You give your blood, then you're a blood 100%. No offense to the Crips. So blood in, blood out, basically. Now the scourging, which leads to the change in outfit, the purple robe, county jail, Christiesis, humiliation once more, the drama of, you know, going through the whole industrial prison complex, whatever it's called. Now he's got his paperwork, his pink slip, make sure he's not a pedophile and stuff like that, so you can show the homeboys inside so he don't, you know, take crap for that. He's locked up, he's in a cell, and he's got a crown of thorns, except it's got a plug in. Why? Because it's like the electric chair, the knowledge of knowing that it's a death sentence. Now he picks up his cross, Golgotha, and goes to the place of the skull to be crucified. Nowadays, roll it up, pick up your mattress, pick up your commissary, you're going to the big house. Picture, you know, labeled a male factor, a black male, which is a crime, and then crucify, even shanked by a guard. Now, only difference is that with Yeshua, we do life everlasting, life eternal. So, one last thing I'd like to add is, we know Yeshua is black, but that doesn't mean that any black person can be the Christ. It's only through His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie I, that we can give an image and likeness, and we can personify accurately the life and character of Christ Yeshua. See, Christ Yeshua, Jesus Christos, is too far removed from our time. That's 2,000 years ago. Anyone can pretend to understand what he said. One must live it, and the only one that has lived it and brought it to the kingdom age, to the age of government, ruling over a whole people, is Edamame Haile Selassie, the first power of the Trinity, at the highest level of human government, operating under the same principles as Christ. Love thy neighbor as thyself. Love thy fellow neighbor nation, neighbor country, neighbor empire, neighbor government or kingdom as thyself. So, the individual sense, His Majesty, the collective sense. Now, only through His Majesty can we get an accurate description of what the word really means, because this image of Christ isn't necessarily His appearance. We can assume that because of His likeness to His Majesty. But let us not be fooled. Only the Father can resurrect the Son in spirit and truth to the real image and likeness that God made Him to. And that is according to the Word. So, you know, not just any black male will do for our Christ. Only through the Father can we see the Son. And no one can see the Son but through the Father, as well as no one can see the Father but through the Son. So, the crucifixion of black male in America. Shalom.